Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Kapendra from Kirodimal College, University of Delhi. Today we are going to talk on module Ecosystem Processes 1, Part 1 from paper Ecology. Learning objectives. After studying this module, you shall be able to understand the concept of ecosystem, list the major type of ecosystem, their structure and function. Understand various types of food chains present in the nature. Understand structure and function of food web. Describe the ecological pyramids and their types. Ecosystem, it can be defined as the assemblies of organisms and their associated environment, which collectively functions as a system to exchange material and energy. The alternative term for ecosystem is known as biogeocenosis. The ecosystem is the ecological hierarchy, is the first unit that is complete. It bears all biological and physical components that are essential for the survival. Ecosystem is inimitable to ecology, as sustained life on Earth is a characteristic of ecosystem, not for individual or population. Types of ecosystem. An ecosystem can be natural or artificial, temporary or permanent, large or tiny. Thus, ecosystem can be categorized into following categories. The first is natural ecosystems. These ecosystems operate and develop in natural ways with no major interference by humans. They are further classified on the basis of kind of habitat as terrestrial ecosystem. The terrestrial ecosystem consists of grassland ecosystem that is dominated by grasses and cover about 20% of land surface. Savanna ecosystem, it consists of grassland with low frequency of trees. Taiga ecosystem, it consists of subalpine ecosystem with low or medium sub-rainfall having acidic soil. Tundra ecosystem, it occurs in alpine zone between taiga and polar ice zone, dominated by lichens, mosses, herbs, grasses, and low shrubs. Desert ecosystem, it consists of ecosystem with very low rainfall, in which warm desert occurs in tropical region and cold desert occurs in temperate zone. And finally, forest ecosystem, which is dominated by trees and found in tropical and temperate zone. Another type of natural ecosystem is aquatic ecosystem. It is further divided into two types. The first is freshwater ecosystem. This type of ecosystem is further categorized as lotic ecosystem. It is an ecosystem of running water as stream or river. And lentic ecosystem, which consists of still water such as lake or pond. Marine ecosystem. These ecosystems include shallow water ecosystem, estuarine ecosystem, and deep sea ecosystem. Artificial ecosystem. Artificial ecosystem are also known as man-made ecosystem. In 1959, Odum classified artificial ecosystem on the basis of photosynthesis respiration ratio into three types. The first type is stabilized ecosystem. This type of ecosystem is formed when photosynthesis by respiration ratio is almost 1. Second type is autotrophic ecosystem. This type of ecosystem is formed when photosynthesis by respiration ratio is more than 1. Third type is heterotrophic ecosystem. This type of ecosystem is formed when photosynthesis by respiration ratio is less than 1. These ecosystems are regularly manipulated by humans, in which addition of energy and natural balance is disturbed at particular period of time. For example, croplands like rice fields, sugarcane, wheat fields, maize, gardens, cities, villages, aquarium, and many more. The natural ecosystems do not have separate boundaries. An ecosystem progressively combines with the adjacent one through a transitional zone called as ecotone. The ecotone consists of species present in two adjacent ecosystems. Generally, the ecotone has other species which is not present in both ecosystems. The ecotone has more population density of certain species as compared to either of the adjoining communities. This phenomenon is known as edge effect. Edge effect can be observed in the coastal zone where the land and the ocean meets. Due to the flow of tides, the coastal zone does not follow the fixed boundaries on the seaward and landward directions. As a result, it provides the place for those organisms who can survive on land as well as in the water, and also increases the biodiversity. It also contains specific plants like mangroves that flourish in salt water. The most common example of ecotone is estuary, where river meets the sea. In estuary, there is a regular mixing of fresh water and seawater, which results in higher biodiversity. Estuary present in Chennai, where the river Adyar meets the sea. It accommodates large number of organisms, including many species of birds. Food chain. In an ecosystem, flow of energy occurs through a series of organisms by eating and being eaten by another organisms comprises a food chain. A food chain is called simple when it has only one trophic level besides the decomposers. A food chain is called complex food chain when it bears both producer and consumer levels. At each level of energy transfer, there is a loss of 80 to 90% of the potential energy in the form of heat energy. All living or dead organisms serve as food for the other organisms, which results in zero wastage of energy in the ecosystem. The number of trophic levels in the food chain is always restricted to 4 or 5, as the available energy decreases with each level, many direct or indirect methods are used to study the relationship of food chain in the nature, including gut content analysis, use of radioactive isotopes, precipitin tests, etc. Types of food chain. In nature, basically two types of food chains are recognized. The first is grazing food chain. Grazing food chain always begins with producers, that are green plants, which produces their food by the process of photosynthesis and then moves through herbivores to carnivores. This type of food chain is directly influenced by influx of the radiant energy from sun. Thus, this grazing food chain depends on the captured energy of autotrophs and then the movements of this energy to the herbivores. The example of food chain is presented in the figure. The second type is detritus food chain. This type of food chain begins with the dead organic wastes and matters which are derived from the grazing food chain are known as detritus. The energy containing in the detritus is utilized by a group of organisms called detritivores that are separate from the grazing food chain. Detritus food chain starts with dead and decaying organic matter and moves through microorganisms like bacteria, fungus, etc. to detritus feeding organisms that are detritivores and then their predators. This chain is not directly dependent on the solar radiant energy. The detritus food chain characterizes an extremely important component of energy flow in the ecosystem. The organisms of the detritus food chain includes bacteria, protozoa, slime mold, fungus, insects, crustaceans, rotifers, centipedes, mollusks, nematodes, annelids, and also some vertebrates. Detritus food chain can be easily explained by example of mangrove leaves, which was studied by Held in 1969 and W. E. Odom in 1970 in brackish zone of southern Florida. The leaves of red mangrove, Rhizophore mangle, when fall into warm, shallow water, only 5% of leaves were consumed by phytophagous insects before it falls. The fragments of fallen leaves are consumed by number of smaller animals, which includes crabs, copepods, insect larvae, nematodes, etc. These organisms are then consumed by as a food by small game fishes and minnows, etc. That is carnivore, which are further eaten by larger game fishes and fish-eating birds, that is the top carnivores. Food web. In nature, food chains are not isolated sequences but are interconnected with each other and make an interlocking pattern. The same organism may operate in the ecosystem at more than one trophic level. That is, it may derive its food from more than one source. Even the same organism may be eaten by several organisms of higher trophic level, or an organism may feed upon several different organisms of lower trophic level. Thus, in a given ecosystem, various food chains are linked together and interrelated with each other to form a complex network called food web. In complex communities, an organism whose food is obtained from the plants by same number of steps belongs to the same trophic level. The producers occupy the first trophic level. Herbivores occupy second trophic level. Carnivores third trophic level. And secondary carnivore occupy fourth trophic level. This trophic level classification is one of the function and not of species. The number of species of predators in the food web typically exceeds the number of species of prey by an average of 1.3 predator species per prey species. The energy flow through trophic level equals to total assimilation at that level, which is equal to the production of the biomass and respiration. Significance of food chain. Both food chain and food web maintains the nutrient cycle and energy flow through them. Food chain play important role to understand the feeding relationship as well as the interaction between organisms in the ecosystem. Food chain helps in maintaining the ecological balance by sustaining the size of populations. Food chain also helps to understand the movement of toxic substances in the ecosystem and the problem of biological magnification. The ecological pyramids represent both the trophic structure as well as the trophic function of ecosystem. The ecological pyramids can be divided into three types. The first is pyramid of number. It represents the total number of individuals at different trophic level in the food chain. The pyramid of number was advanced by Charles Elton in 1927, who explained that there is difference in the number of organisms present in each step of the food chain. The organisms present at the base of pyramid are the most plentiful. The successive trophic levels of the pyramid decrease rapidly in the number until there are few carnivores present at the top. The lake ecosystem provides an example of pyramids of number. In lake ecosystem, base of the pyramid is occupied by producers. These are more in number as compared to herbivores. The second trophic level is represented by primary consumers, which include zooplanktons, which are less in number. The third trophic level is occupied by secondary consumers, which includes small and medium-sized fishes, which further reduced in number. The top of the pyramid is occupied by tertiary consumers, which includes large fishes, which are minimum in numbers. In the parasitic food chain, the pyramid of number is reversed for the successive steps. Thus, the parasites are more in number as compared to the hosts. Pyramid of biomass. The living weight of the organism present at any time in each trophic level forms the pyramid of biomass. Pyramid of biomass indicate gradual decrease of biomass in successive trophic level from base to top of the pyramids. For example, the total biomass of the producers ingested by herbivores is more than the total biomass of the herbivores in an ecosystem. Similarly, the total biomass of the primary carnivores will be less than the herbivores, and so on, as some amount of energy or material is lost from lower trophic level to upper trophic level. The total biomass supported at each trophic level is restricted by the rate at which energy is being stored at the next lower level. In other words, the biomass of producers should be large to support the herbivores. Similarly, the biomass of the herbivores should be more than that of carnivores. The successive decrease of biomass from lower to upper trophic level causes narrowing of pyramid in most of the ecosystem. But this is not true for all ecosystems. Ecosystems such as lakes and oceans, primary productivity are restricted to phytoplanktons. They have short life cycle and fast reproduction. These phytoplanktons are heavily grazed by herbivores, which are larger in size and have longer life span. Thus, despite the high productivity of producers, they have low biomass as compared to herbivores. It results in an inverted pyramid, having low standing crop biomass of producers than herbivores. Similarly, in the case of parasites like pyramid of number, the pyramid of biomass is inverted. Pyramid of energy. It indicates the total amount of energy at each trophic level of the food chain. It also exhibits that at each trophic level, loss of energy occurs due to the process of assimilation and growth. Thus, at the producer level, total energy is more than at higher trophic level. When productivity is measured in terms of energy, the pyramids specify not only the energy flow at each level, but also the actual role played by various organisms in the transfer of energy. Some organisms have smaller biomass, but they assimilate and transfer more energy than that of organisms having much larger biomass. The pyramid of energy always show sloping because there is always declining of transferred energy from one trophic level to other. In the open water communities, the producers have less biomass than consumers, but they store and transfer more energy than that of next level. The high energy flow is maintained by a rapid turnover of individual plankton instead of increase of total mass. So students, let us summarize what we had learned in this module. In ecosystem, all biotic and abiotic components of the environment are connected through energy flow and nutrient cycle. An ecosystem can be natural or artificial, temporary or permanent, and large or small. An ecosystem progressively combines with the adjacent one through a transitional zone called as ecotone. It has more population density of certain species than either of the adjoining communities. This phenomenon is known as edge effect. In an ecosystem, flow of energy occurs through a series of organisms by eating and being eaten by another organisms comprises a food chain. The food chain is simple when it has only one trophic level besides the decomposers. It became complex when it bears both producers and consumer levels. Food chain can be categorized as grazing food chain and detritus food chain. The grazing food chain begins with producers, which produces their food by the process of photosynthesis, and then moves through herbivores to carnivores. The detritus food chain begins with the dead organic wastes and matters. In an ecosystem, various food chains are linked together and interconnected with each other to form a complex network which is known as food web. In food chain, the number and mass of the organisms in each trophic level is limited by amount of energy available. This relationship is known as ecological pyramids. Pyramids of number represents the total number of individuals at different trophic level in food chain. Pyramid of biomass represents the living weight of the organism present at any time in each trophic level. Pyramid of energy indicates the total amount of energy at each trophic level of the food chain.